First question is from Just a Youngin. How do you train someone that only wants to commit to 1 to 2 workouts a week?
Very carefully.
Yeah, that's it. Next question. Now, this is I like this question. Here's why. When I was a new trainer, when people would tell me that they can only work out 1 or 2 work times a week, I literally would think that's a waste of time. And in fact, I know I turned away potential clients because they refused to commit to working out at least 3 days a week or 4 days a week.
Oh, you're not ready yet.
Yeah. In fact, part of my strategy when I was a new trainer, I've always, you know, enjoyed, you know, discussing and being persuasive, right? So I'd get this person in front of me and I'd say, how many days a week can you commit to the gym? And they'd say, oh, just 1 day a week. And then the rest of the time, my goal was to persuade them to commit to 3 or 4 days a week because in my eyes, 1 day a week just wasn't effective. Now, I realized after years of doing this, literally 5 or 6, 5 years maybe, that it was a terrible strategy. The strategy was terrible because the reality is if you're going from 0 days a week of working out to any more than that days of working out, that's a benefit. And on top of that, it's not just a physical benefit. It's beneficial because the way people develop long-term behavioral changes typically is a little bit at a time. So later on, my strategy became, hey, I can only work out 1 day a week. And I'd say, no problem. We'll design a workout around that and make sure it's as effective as possible. Now, as far as how would I train someone? Well, if I'm only training them once or twice a week, first off, a lot of it depends on the person. If I need to focus a lot on mobility work, which is usually the case with a brand new client, then most of my workout is going to be mobility work. As they progress and they need less and less of that special focus mobility work, more of it goes to traditional resistance training. If the person comes to me and they don't have tons of mobility issues, then I'll do a normal priming session or, you know, warm up, for example. And then I'm doing just a full body resistance training routine. And it's mainly revolving around compound lifts, you know, squats and overhead presses and rows and that kind of stuff.
So I would do exactly the same thing, except I guess another depends, right? Is sometimes somebody who says 1 to 2 times a week, it's because they're saying that like maybe just Saturday and Sunday they have an option to work out. And so the days are back to back. So that's the only way I would split it. I agree with Sal. Someone who's probably only able to commit to 1 or 2 days a week is probably also the clients that probably need a lot of mobility. So I would say that the bulk of my training would be focused around their posture and dealing with any sort of chronic pain and those issues. Then the other portion of it would obviously be a full body type of routine, unless it's back to back days. So if it's if their 2 days are back to back, then I would probably do a split where I went upper body 1 day, lower body the other day, and I would just the only difference that I do is like, so let's say Sal's riding it the way he just said, where he has a full body routine twice a week. He's probably going to do 2 to 3 sets of each body part on there. If I know that I'm only going to get that body part once that week, I might do 4 to 5, right? So right. I might do 4 to 5 sets for every body part in the upper body on one workout, and then the other workout, I would do 4 to 5 sets in the lower body workouts if I was going to go back-to-back workouts. If I had a minimum of 2 to 3 days in between the 2 days, then I would do exactly what you alluded to, which is a full body routine with mobility work is what that would look like.
Yeah, brand new client. I mean, this would be something I would definitely start to build up their specific mobility routine, their priming session, you know, ahead of time to really focus in on that, because they can repeat that the whole rest of the week as they, you know, have time available. They can do that at their house. But like, I would slowly build onto that with, you know, I'd take one compound lift and really try to, you know, teach them specifically the mechanics and the technique involved, and then have them practice it with light weight. You know, if that's the only amount of time I'm allotted, and go through that for a couple of weeks until I can really build up, you know, trust that they're going to perform this exercise correctly throughout the rest of the week.
You know, I want to add to something you said, Sal, that I think is important to reiterate for the trainers that are listening, is I too was like this, where at the beginning I did not, I get frustrated with this client. I'd say, oh, you know, you're not serious enough, or if you really want to see results, we need to be training at least 3 times a week if I want to see it. And to be honest, later in my career, I actually preferred this too.
Totally.
I mean, I would much rather, in fact, I found myself talking clients down that were like all motivated because they had something coming up where they're like, oh, I could give you 5 days a week. And I'm like, well, when was the last time you trained 5 days a week. And they'd be like, well, never, but I know now yeah. I have the time. And then I would actually end up going, you know what, let's start off with just one or two times, build a really solid routine and a good habit, and then we could start to build off of that.
Well, also, I mean, you're teaching them to fish. You're teaching them how to figure this out for themselves as well, like this type of a client versus somebody that's coming in and they're relying on you the entire time to just tell them what to do and be mindless, about the entire program of it. Like really spending the time to educate them mm-hmm. in that 1 to 2 days that you have available is going to be super worthwhile.
Yeah, and you know, you can actually get 2 days a week, you can get exceptional results.
Oh, yeah.
That Doug worked out with me 2 days a week.
Definitely.
For the first, I think, year or two that we trained together. So Doug went from, you know, normal active guy to deadlifting twice his body weight. And there's this before and after picture that I've posted in the past where you could see his abs and all that. That was 2 days a week of resistance training. Now, the other days he was active on his own normally, but really it was only two structured workouts a week. You can get very far with two really, really good resistance training workouts.
You can not only get really far, you can also maintain a decent physique at that.
Totally.
I mean, I'm training that right now. One, maybe two times of resistance training a week right now. Now, by no means am I impressive, but I also don't look like I don't work out. You know, you can maintain, especially if your programming is tight and you are doing the biggest bang for your buck movements, man, if you're deadlifting and squatting and overhead pressing and benching twice a week, you're going to have a pretty damn good physique and base.
That's one of the things I love most about resistance training. It sends the signal, and then the body does the work. So it's not like you have to manually building muscle there. Like with cardio, you have to manually burn calories. With resistance training, you're setting the gears in motion. And so if it's effective, it can be infrequent. And that's one of the hallmarks of resistance training. It's one of the reasons why it's one of the best ways to exercise, especially with our current busy lifestyles.